In an 8 on Your Side exclusive, a military hero turned oath keeper weighs in on his arrest for the January 6th siege on the Capitol. Good evening, I'm Stacey Scheibel.
And I'm Josh Benson. Thanks for being with us tonight. A retired decorated veteran, now a member of the paramilitary oath-keeping organization, gives us his inside view of the violent assault on our Capitol.
He won 2 Bronze Stars while serving our country, but now he faces possible prison time for charges he says he will fight. 8 on Your Side, senior investigator Walt Buteau joins us live from the Tampa News Center to explain.
Jeremy Brown says evidence shows the FBI knew he was in the Capitol during the insurrection, and he claims his arrest 9 months later is less about what he did and more about what he said in his public comments since January 6th. Jeremy Brown tells me he is behind the door in this surveillance video that he says shows 2 FBI agents at his Tampa home in early December. He says about 5 days later, on the 9th of that month, he met with agents here in a central Ybor courtyard.
Within 38 seconds of walking up to them, they made mention of me working with them to see how interested I might be in working for them as a confidential informant against groups I may be involved with. I believe that they already knew something was going to happen.
Brown spoke with me from the Pinellas County Jail, saying he was one of about 20 members of the Florida chapter of the Oath Keepers organization asked to provide security for a January 6th rally. By the end of what erupted into violence, 5 people were dead, roughly 150 injured, and more than 600 arrested, including 69 Floridians so far.
We weren't even anywhere close to the Capitol when we got word that the Capitol had been breached. So the idea that the Oath Keepers orchestrated some kind of conspiracy, I mean, this is the game that they play.
The government has alleged otherwise in several cases involving members of the Oath Keepers and Proud Boys groups. Brown is charged with knowingly entering restricted grounds and engaging in disorderly or disruptive conduct, and a felony firearms charge after agents alleged 2 illegal guns and 2 hand grenades were confiscated from Brown's home. A judge ordered the 47-year-old held in custody, citing what he said was a specific threat to law enforcement in this note written by Brown. At the end of the page, officers were told, quote, to bring a bigger tactical package if they returned. According to Brown, he wrote the note as a verbal jab at the feds and never had the intent of actually assaulting law enforcement. Brown, who served in Iraq and Afghanistan and was featured in this decades-old Special Forces recruiting poster, says he will fight the charges.
I'm not accepting any plea deals. My purpose is to bring attention to the fact that the FBI tried to infiltrate a law-abiding group of American citizens.
Several other insurrection defendants have entered guilty pleas and agreed to cooperate with the government. The FBI declined our request to comment on Brown's claims.
So, Walt, did he mention what evidence he wants the government to release specifically?
He did. He talked about what could be learned from so far unreleased Capitol surveillance video. He also hopes to learn more about unindicted co-conspirators referenced in several federal charging documents.
All right. Walt Buteau live in the Tampa.